Good evening, and thank you so much for taking your time to come to my presentation. I made a psychedelic POV film, and before I begin, I'd like to say that I know this topic may be sensitive to some of you guys, and I'm willing to take any questions you guys might have during the Q&A session later in the presentation. So let's begin. But for inspiration, I am an avid fan of A$AP Rocky and Frank Ocean, and I found that their music videos have a common theme of creating like this psychedelic vibe and portraying a message without explicitly expressing the message. So that was kind of what I was trying to do. Obviously, their work is a lot more professional and better than mine, but so here are some of the videos that inspired me. If you look at the titles written down below, you'll see what I'm talking about. And to begin, for the research process, I personally never have experienced this psychedelic effect myself, so I had to look to YouTube of what it may look like, and I also looked to YouTube for tutorials of how to use professional tools such as Adobe After Effects and other editing programs that I had to use. But I did have some experience doing this sort of thing when I worked during the summer. And yeah, if you saw me walking around with the phone attached to my head with the body cam, this was what I was making. I had to explain to a lot of people what I was trying to do. It does look grotesque and bizarre what I was doing. And here's a clip provided by Matty Norris to show some of the process. Yeah, so as you can hear, a lot of people questioned what I was doing, and I did have to explain to a lot of people as I was walking by. And perhaps the biggest challenge was the sensitivity of the project and the recent events. And some people proposed to me that I should steer the direction of my project. I did have to seriously consider that, but I decided to stick on to it because I believe this is my individual expression. And it's and the fragile nature of the videos. If I took one step too big and the video was shaken up, I had to do this stuff all over again. So that was kind of hard. And finding the right environment to shoot was also a difficulty because what I had in mind was mostly places off campus. However, due to the circumstances, I had to shoot on the campus, but I'm glad it worked out well. And I also had to find times where people aren't work walking. And the quality of the video was not the greatest because I was shooting the video on my refurbished iPhone 10. Having a regular camera attached to my head would have been a lot more difficult, so I had no choice but to use my phone. And my goals for the project was to confuse the viewer's eyes and create this obviously a psychedelic effect, but my main goal was to address the negative effects of psychedelics on the mind and the mental state and to advocate against it, and also to hide symbolism in the video, as I mentioned earlier. And things I want to explain mostly in this presentation was the symbolism I tried to hide. I was hoping the video would be open-ended so the viewers can interpret it however they like, but here is what I was thinking when I made the video. So yeah, let's get it rolling. So to start off the elevator scene, so I kind of use this as like a symbolism that he has reached his destination. An elevator takes you to a higher place, so it is implying that the protagonist is high and he is entering a different mental state of mind. So as a door opens, he like kind of enters this different world after feeling the effects of the drug. And the static effect shown above in the image was used in the early stages of the video as the protagonist was doing drugs in the bathroom, and it shows his damaged state of mind and mental distress from continual use of drugs. And the vibrant colors, I used them to explicitly like show that he was under the influence. And the dance scene, so this is more like a storyline type of deal. He falls in love with this imaginary figure that he created in his mind. So the person he was dancing with in the movie was not real, and he is not actually wearing a suit, and he panics when he finds out that he is just an illusion and it is not real. And the dots in the black background was to show that he is dreaming. So this was like a transition between the dance scene and the scene after when it switches to like the daytime. So he did fall asleep in the quad, and this was kind of like a representation or an illustration of his dreams. And then he enters a flashback near the which was taking place in the Bergen, which was all in a dream. And the messages appearing in front of his eyes. So this kind of is like was a scene that illustrates a bad trip, and these self-induced like negative messages pops up in front of his eyes, and he tries to kick the door and escape this state of mind. And as you can tell, this was like the part where I show the negative effects of psychedelics and how bad it can influence your state of mind. And then the protagonist breaks out of the state of mind. He enters a hallway and then kicks the door, leading to a bright day. And I was really lucky that this USPS truck was driving by, because this kind of emphasized that he is now in the real world now, and other people are just going on in their lives, and it represents sobriety. And the voices that he hears in his head shows like the trauma and the after effects of the psychedelics even after he's sober. And the sound effect of the seatbelt and the beeping represented like it's a car, it's a sound from like cars when you like get off the car. So that kind of like that was like a metaphor for the end of the trip. And he sits down on the bench and relaxes, and that was like the end of the trip. And my final thoughts for the video, I just so I'm just gonna go over the minor details. And so the Russian letters were to like imply the distorted languages like being perceived due to the effects of the psychedelics. And I hid every faces in the video because I thought that showing the faces would make it more realistic and would damage like the idea that he is under the influence. And thank you so much, Alex Edwards and Lucy, for being in the video. Lucy is the one dancing and Alex is the dealer. They made the video so much better than it should be, and I wouldn't have done it without them. So thank you guys so much. And I really enjoyed making this video, although it was really hectic and the resources were limited, but it turned out better than I thought. So thank you, Miss Pixler, and everyone that helped me for making this project. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, hopefully. And I will take any questions. You guys can feel free to ask anything about the video, and I will also answer your questions about the sensitive nature of the project. But thank you so much for taking your precious time and coming to my presentation, and I hope you guys have a great night. Thank you.